Mayors of cities around the country are urging Congress to think twice before enacting far-reaching federal spending cuts that they say could devastate local economies. The federal spending cuts, you've heard this term before, they're known as sequestration, are set to go into effect this January as a result of last year's failed budget discussions. When Democrats and Republicans reached a deadlock on their negotiations, a plan was set up so that budget cuts of $1.2 trillion would automatically go into effect in 2013. Here's Atlanta's Mayor Kasim Reed.
We are not going to stand by in cities across the United States of America and allow the federal government to shift its responsibilities to us and go by quietly. We're going to raise this issue in 131 cities across the United States of America, and we're going to make it known that cuts without revenue isn't a cut really at the federal level. It will mean that those burdens and those responsibilities will go to cities that are already constrained and doing everything we can do to keep our city functioning well.
Kasim Reed, Mayor of Atlanta, joins me now. Good morning, Mr. Mayor.
Thank
you for being here.
No, thank you for having me.
So the 130 or so mayors standing with you, they're Republicans and Democrats?
Bipartisan across the United States of America.
So we always hear if these cuts go into place, they'll affect the Defense Department and they'll affect social programs. But we don't hear how they'll affect cities across America. How will they affect Atlanta?
Well, the segment that you played regarding the crisis in Pittsburgh is a prime example. We have 50 police officers who were funded as a part of a grant from the federal government. We have a SAFER grant with 75 firefighters. You just had a segment with the police chief of Pittsburgh. What we're doing right now is, in a very bad economy, we're doing everything we can to keep our folks safe. We've stood up the largest police force in the history of the city of Atlanta, and we did so in an open and honest fashion in cooperation with the federal government. So they shouldn't walk away from their commitments to us after we went and made financial commitments because they're not willing to do their work in a thoughtful, serious way.
So you're coming out early with this because they probably won't begin negotiating until after the first of the year. So do you expect things to go badly?
Well, the fact of the matter is by the time they start actually negotiating, then there'll be too much noise for us to break through. But mayors are in every major media market in America. You pick a major media market, there's a major city with a mayor. And what we're doing right now is making it real clear to the federal government and to Congress that we're not going to sit by while you shift your cost to the local area while you claim that you're cutting taxes.
Do you think it will make any difference who is elected president as far as how those negotiations will go?
Well, I think it always makes a difference because President Obama has been so much more supportive of cities. But on this measure, we're focused on it in a bipartisan way without regard to who is elected, because we think that there is a major federal effort. If you go with $1.2 trillion and across-the-board cuts, we're all going to be harmed. And we want people to know right here and right now, cities, we're doing our jobs. The things that they get away with in Washington, D.C., we couldn't get away with for one day because we have real responsibilities. We balance our budgets every single year, and we can't print money. So we're just telling folks, do your job in Washington while we do ours in Atlanta and cities across America.
So I'm curious, when you watch our federal lawmakers going at one another, what goes through your mind?
What goes through my mind is when people with important jobs don't do their job, real people get harmed. See, I can't focus on these grand issues that they're focused on in Washington. I've got to focus on making sure that when a mom walks to her car, that she gets there safe. I've got to make sure that when someone places a 911 call, that police or fire respond. And if they don't, I hear from it from people who are on the other end of that telephone with real lives. So we're not going to allow what is going on in Washington to damage cities, which is where 80% of our country's economic productivity is. If they allow these $1.2 trillion in cuts to go ahead, if they don't do their work, just as we all do, you go to work every day and I go to work every day, 2 million people's jobs are at risk. So we're not going to wait until the middle of the noise and all of the congressional blame game. We're going to be in major markets every single day talking about this issue right now.
Mayor Reed, thanks so much for being with us this morning. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
When we come back, of course, we'll